legal framework that we're working is helpful, and it facilitates the implementation and acceptance by the governments of the work that we're doing. And of course, the international targets that are set in the framework of the CBD also will help in speeding up the process. But at the same time, we know that we have actually seen that in a lot of the small countries that we work with, as the South Caucasus countries, for example, there is very much a limited expertise. Sometimes, for some of the species, groups, you have only one or two experts, and we definitely have to involve them. It doesn't mean that the expertise is not there. It's just to speak to the right persons. A lot of the data that the governments are using is very old or sometimes missing. Support is needed in that, and from the process that we're implementing, we have definitely seen that cooperation with the NGO sectors, between the NGO sector and the national authorities, is extremely important, because there is expertise and data available within the NGO sector, and this, and we are trying to push the national authorities to work with that sector. The link with the international ICN categories is also helpful. A lot of the governments that we work with, when they are trying to identify areas which are go beyond their nationally protected areas, to include them in the network, they're first thinking about what category they will put into that areas. When they have to, they will have to manage them later on. So this really gives a framework for thought and reflection. But of course, we have seen also that there is an added value of the work that we are doing in many of the countries that we are active in, like Armenia or Belarus or Ukraine. The work is a sort of a trigger for including additional areas in legally designate them at national level to create new protected areas, to also improve a lot of the knowledge at national level and help countries develop their inventories on biodiversity at national level. We have seen also a sort of a movement at the level of the NGO sector with citizen science and nature conservation that are feeding into the process that we're implementing. So this is also another value of this cooperation that we're trying to create and to push for at national level. There have been also a good outcome of the work at the level of interministerial cooperation. In some countries, have even been a process of creation of national agencies which are on environment, which have really been lacking and which could facilitate the process of ratification of the areas and sort of agreement of all sorts of sectors on the necessity that this or that area should be included in the network. And there is also another important point, which is the update of the list of the species and the habitats that we are targeting. Because these lists are mostly Western European based, simply because at the moment of their creation, of their agreement upon them, a lot of these Eastern European countries who are not yet contracted parties to the convention, countries like Belarus have joined us only last year, for example. So there is a whole process of trying to include. To first list new species and habitats, to describe them and then to propose them to the Secretary of the Convention so we can include them in the list of species that will be targeted by the future emerald sites. So I don't have any maps to present. It was a bit difficult to put it on a map. We also target the Russian Federation, but at least the European part of the Russian Federation, and it's very hard to present all that on a map. But very briefly to say that for the moment, as we have started the work a few years ago, we have a bit more than 2,500 sites that are identified, and of course we push for more areas to be included. Governments have, this is also another political, governments have already included some of them. The Emerald Network has an objective in the national strategies, and we hope that this process will continue. And last but not least, I would like to mention also extremely fruitful cooperation with BirdLife in Europe. They have been extremely helpful in providing us the data for the that will be very helpful for the evaluation of the areas that are proposed so far. Therefore, that's why we also look forward to progress in the KBA project of BioCN, and this will be very helpful. Yesterday we will be discussing also this on how international conventions can use